Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the If I Produced For series. And today we're going to say If I Produced for Travis Scott. So firstly, I'm going to start with sound design because I find that's the most inspiration for my song. Now before we even get into sound design, let's start with chords. I'm going to start with FL keys just to lay down the tone, but I'm going to go back and design my own sound. So I want to go for that churchy feel. So we're at about 128 BPM. So a lot of church, especially black church, they like to use the black keys, I guess because it's easier to play, even though it's hard to play. But it's easy to come up with melodies just using the black keys. You know, you're just kind of like, you know. Okay, so what we're going to do is work off of pseudo-leading tones. So for example, let me figure out which octave we're in. This is going to be our first note. Now, I'm copying the rhythm, but you can go back and change the chords. But keep in mind, to get the same mood, you have to use the same chords in the same sequence. That's what mood is. Mood is created by chords in a specific context. It's not the chord by itself. It's chords in context which create moods. So if you want a similar mood, okay, we're just going up the scale, playing one note at a time. So I'm going to use that rhythm. Let's turn up the BPM just a little bit more. So this is our scale. I'm just going up note by the scale. So it's A sharp, C. Then we're going to C sharp or D flat. And following the scale back upwards. So it goes down, up the scale, then to the middle of the scale, going back up. And you can create your own. I want to go dun 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 dun. Okay, now what you need to do is build out that melody and turn it into a chord. In short, we show you how to do this in Chord Magic at BusyWorksBeats.com/chordmagic. You can literally take one note and build out the chord for it. I'm going to use those techniques today. We explained it in much more depth in our Chord Magic 2 course at BusyWorksBeats.com/chordmagic. So if you want the explanation fully, go click that link below. So I'm going to turn these into chords. Using these as what we call pseudo leading tones, I'm going to assume they're the top notes of some chord. So let's start back. Now it could be a minor, but let's try major. I think minor would probably be the better start. Now, it doesn't have to be minor or major. It could also be other chord types. But I'm going to assume it's a minor or a major just to make this easier to work through. Okay, now here you can either extend this chord or you can build this chord out. So I'm just transposing to make this, you know, quicker workflow. But there's a technique behind this. I know I'm not explaining every little thing. So those are the quote-unquote proper chords. And notice I'm not mapping out the scale, trying to do all this stuff in between. It's a quicker way to do it. Okay, we know B is in the chord, and we know G. One of these notes sounds off. So I'm going to use that root note twice. Now one of these notes, okay. So what my ear is tricking me into doing is using some note that's not what we call the pseudo leading tone. We're trying to use those notes as the leading tone, but they weren't the leading tone from the beginning. They weren't that inner built-in melody. So what my ear is trying to do is pick up on the attention of other notes that aren't important. So I need to remember they're not important as far as the attention. So this would be 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay, now you can get fancy and change up the chords and do all these different things. I'm gonna leave it as simple as possible. We can always go back and change the music. I'm just doing this so we can get the chords right, and I'm gonna build a sound around this. I'm gonna add this as an extra tone. One of these chords sounds off, so let me check the chord code. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. But something feels off. So since I'm not using the scale, it could be a different chord type, like a diminished chord. So let me see where the which note sounds sour. So it's this G sharp that's, you know, pulling my ear's attention. So let's either pull it up or pull it down one. And if it doesn't sound good, then we'll find a different solution. I think it might just be the piano. It just might be the sound. So let's not worry about that. Now let's open up Silenth. And we're going to program our own sound. I'm going to get pretty quirky with the sound design. This is not for beginners, so I apologize if I'm going too fast, but we need to keep pushing through the video. So, you know, let's turn our polyphony up. One thing I'm going to do is set it to sine wave. That sounded like a better interval. I think maybe that was supposed to be a major chord. Maybe that's why. Maybe not. Anyway, so we need to give this a decay. A sustain, which is lower than the decay. Give it a little release so it doesn't have those clicks and pops. A tiny bit of attack. Now I'm going to add another oscillator. Let's change this to a different waveform, like a triangle, an octave lower. I'm going to turn that volume down. I'm going to turn it up to two voices, detune them. Now I want to give it motion. So let's add a low pass filter. And I'm going to use a mod envelope to control cutoff A. This is the max value of the cutoff. This is the minimum value. I'm going to add some resonance. Also going to give this a little release tail. Now I still want to give it more motion, so I'm going to go to the LFO. I'm either going to modulate cutoff A, or I'm going to add some other noise and modulate that pretty quickly. But let's do volume AB for now, so it adds a tremolo effect. So you hear that kind of wobble. Let's turn the voices up to 2 for the main sound. I like that tone a lot better. It sounds more FM, even though we haven't introduced FM synth. I'm going to turn on portamento. So it kind of pitch bends between chords. And on part B, I'm going to copy part A's sine wave, paste that in. And I want to use this as a regular octave. And we want it to run through filter B with a low pass filter. I'm going to copy the state from filter A, paste it into filter B, and change this to cutoff A and B so they have the same modulation. Just going to pull in the stereo width of the higher frequency. Let's add another oscillator. This is just for texture. So I'm adding four voices of a square wave detuned, so it adds like a chorusy percussion top end. Now also we need to copy our envelope settings, paste them in. This one I'm going to give a little more decay and turn B up because this is going to serve as the transient. I'm going to take down the, what I'm going to do actually, let's do this. Let's copy the mod envelope, paste it, and let's tell cutoff B to have a different envelope. I want cutoff A to be the body of the sound. We'll cut off B to be the decay portion. So it creates like an FM style sound. And it's very percussive on layer B versus layer A. So that's what we're doing there. Now I'm still iffy about this chord change. There's probably some tension involved here that I'm not focused on. I like that better than what we had before. There's just something about this G sharp that I'm not liking, but let's try some solutions. I like this better. Okay, now there's a couple things I did which we explain in Chord Magic. Let's pull everything down an octave. You hear how that body of the sounds like doo-hoo-hoo. Let's turn down that sustain on layer A. Let's go into our mixer. I'm going to add fruity delay. Ping pong mode. Let's turn the pan width up. Turn down the input volume. Let's open up fruity reverb so we can widen up the sound a bit. I'm going to cut out any bass multipliers. I'm actually going to cut out bass frequencies. Open up the high cut so we can hear high frequency. And lower the decay time. Up the pre-delay just a bit, 50 milliseconds. So now it has a life, you know, it's not just keys anymore. Okay, so now we need, once we're done the customized sound design, let's move into the Moog sound. Now I'm starting to like the Mini V2 from Arteria. I like the sound. It gives you a little more of a realistic sound. Even though I do like Reactor's Monarch, I'm starting to like MIDI 5 a little bit more. Well, in certain contexts, I should say. So let's go to All, and I want to reset this. So let's go to Templates, Template Synth, and let's go to Template 1 Oscillator. So it's nothing there. We're going to build out our own Moog. Now, I like to do Moogs first because I like to be expressive and then cut away stuff that's too, you know, too much, too busy. We can cut that stuff out later. Also, we need tropical percussion, which we're probably going to get from a Battery 4 library. And then I'm going to try and introduce a distorted 808. It might fit with this genre. It might not. So it's going to be an experiment to see if it could fit in. So let me scoot up here. And let's start with our Moog. So the Moog is going to be the bass. The Moog bass is probably the bass you like, but you don't know what it is. It's a style of synthesizer. And it's really catered to a bass sound, mostly. Now, you can get great leads out of it as well, but It's known for its very unique bass sound. It's like a creamy sound. That's how I like to describe it. So let's start out with the music, and then we're going to start building the sound around the music. Let me drop this down an octave. So when it goes bum, ba-na-na. So here I'm going to be really creative, and there's no kind of work through with this except that I'm applying melody magic techniques to this. We go over this in our course called Melody Magic at busyworksbeats.com/melody magic. A lot of people ask me, how do you create bass lines? Bass lines take techniques from melody. So if you go to Melody Magic, you can learn techniques that I'm applying to the bass line. I like to do a lot of octave play with my bass. That's just my personal thing. I'm going to switch this to triplet timing. So let's go to our snap to grid, change it to 1/3 beat. This is going to sound better when I transpose the octaves. I'm just trying different things. So I know I'm being all over the place, but I just want to get this out of the way. Doing slide notes here to make it a little more like we're playing on the keyboard. You don't just play notes one by one all the time. So I want to go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So that's how it's going to work. Then we go 1, 2, 3. So that should be good enough. Now let's start programming the sound. I'm going to pull everything basically down an octave, hitting control down. So it's a little hard to see this interface, and I apologize, but that's how it's built. I'm going to activate oscillator 2 here, reset it if it has any pitch change. I'm going to pull it up an octave. Also, the first oscillator is a saw, this one's a square. I'm gonna make them both a saw. Then let's open up oscillator 3. Reset the pitch, sounds out of tune. Oh, you know what? It needs to be on key switch or key tracking. Now this one's gonna be down an octave. Now we need to add a filter to kind of take away all the brightness. You can also give the filter an envelope, which is hard to see, but this is A, D, and S for attack, decay, sustain. To hear the decay, you need to turn sustain off. Also, I think we need to turn on the envelope. With filter modulation. That's if you want a lot of transients. Let's give it a little tap. That's too much, never mind. So the minimum value is going to be your cutoff frequency when you use the decay knob. I know this is confusing, but if you're trying to learn sound design, we have a whole free course for beginners. Go to busyworksbeats.com/sounddesign. You can learn a lot more about synthesis. Let's try coursing. Or you can try the overall detune knob. This is the creamy sound I'm talking about, but we can't really hear it. So there should be a legato button somewhere. Let's turn glide mode on and legato on. Now, I don't like the kind of transient, so let me take that back out with the decay. Now I have to go on the MIDI and make sure notes overlap where I want them to. I can be a little more creative with it, but I don't want to spend too much time on this. I think it needs a little more bass. Turning filter modulation off. So that's the baseline. So we can cut it and paste as we want. Now we need tropical percussion. Here's where I'm going to go into the Battery 4 library. So let me open up the Battery 4 library. So a lot of the influence came from Drake's Hotline Bling song. So you're going to hear a lot of this tropical percussion. So let's go to the Battery library. Let's go to samples. Let's go to drums. Always mix this up every time. Is it kits or samples? No, samples. Okay. Drums. And let's try some percussion. Let's start with lighter percussion, and then you can think about claps. I wouldn't choose the kicks in this case. I mean, whatever you want. I'm not going to tell you what to use. Let's start with wooden percussion first. Like something like this is very lightweight, tropical. This one, any kind of clav samples or clave samples. This one here. So we're gonna try all these. This might be too, you know, too tropical, but let's see if we add that. Let's just add this for fun. Okay, so let's start sending stuff to the mixer, and then we're going to add some drums. We have enough percussion. We might grab some bongos actually. Now, I don't want to overkill, but let's see if we can find some hand percussion or bongos, hand drums. I like that one because it's very synthy and it's very sine wave based, so we can always give it a tone. That one's good. Okay, so we have enough. I don't want to, you know, you could spend all day going through percussion. It's one of those things where percussion, you could add so much of it that you could spend all day worrying about sound selection. So we have enough elements. Now what I like to do before I add the kicks and the snare is to create percussion on 2 to 3 different patterns based on their percussion style. So I'll do lightweight percussion or clave based, then I'll do bongo based, then I'll do, you know, stuff like the vibra slap on a completely different pattern. I don't do everything all at once. So let's do that. Let's come up with some sub rhythms. So I want to go ch-ch-ch-ch. I'm just going to create little small little clips. Okay, so now we need to worry about time differences. So let's go to the wrench tool, turn up time shift, so things don't hit at the same exact time. Also, you want to pan different percussion. In short, I'm going to pan the clave, the main one, left. Everything else is going to be balancing that clave hitting on the right. Pattern 4, and I think we left off at the claves. I'm gonna pitch this up, so it goes bink, bink. I'm gonna leave that one out because it's not pitching the right way. So I'm gonna go boom, boom, clink. So let's add those in. All we need to do, we don't need to overkill. I'm gonna time shift the first bongo. Okay, so everything in the mixer is trying to be, it's fighting for attention, so we need to turn stuff down. Have enough percussion. Now let's add the vibra slap effect. I'm gonna EQ out the low end with the parametric EQ 2 by using a high pass filter. We're gonna chop out the low end. Then I'm gonna run it through a reverb, a long tail reverb, cut out the lows. You could add this just for like creepiness. I mean, even though it's not too creepy of a sound, make it more of a haunted sound with the reverb tail. I'm going to add the bongos to the left to kind of balance out. Six. Let's start adding the drums. Let's make this hard trap. Let's go to busyworksbeats.com. Let's go to the X drums. Let's start darkening this up, making it more aggressive. I'm going to use kick IH. Kick NK is a little aggressive for this tone. Too boomy. Let's grab a snare. Now we're going to use the bounce snare. 808 snare, so we get a clean tone. We're not looking for any texture for the drums because that might eat up too much space. Let's add the drums in. I'm gonna turn the kick up. Now everything's trying to be loud, so let's turn everything else down for now. Now I know that threatened the volume of the video, so let's turn that back up. Let's turn the kick up. Really need to turn stuff down because I shouldn't have to crank sounds this loud. So we're gonna do the bounce snare, which is boom, clap, 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 clap. And I'm going to layer that with an 808 clap, and I'm going to delay the main clap so it doesn't hit at the same exact time as that bouncy snare. I'm saying clap, I meant to say snare. Let's turn that bass down. Clone this so that feels like a better rhythm. I might redo the bass line if it conflicts with this rhythm. Boom, boom, ch, boom, 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 ch, boom. Okay, now let's start turning stuff down. So it starts messing up after the first bar. I'm not going to sit here and redo the whole bass line. Sometimes I like the synth, sometimes I don't. Again, I'm not going to focus on the minutiae. Let's add one cymbal just to kind of add more aggression to the downbeat. Let's add a crash cymbal. I'm going to muffle out the bass so it's not bright. Kick is pitched too low, so let me pitch it up. Now we can insert an 808, so let's grab the 808s from X Drums. Now I'm gonna mute the Moog. I'm gonna use 808X. Let's right click, go to edit, go to the marker tab, go to detect pitch regions. This one's in the key of A, so let's go to the envelope, reset, and let's right click on the note A. I'm going to run this through distortion so it's a brighter 808, and we're going to use this for aggression. I'm not going to use it right away, however. I might even use it soloed because I don't want to overkill the distorted 808. You know, it's not a distorted 808 type of vibe. It's more of like a Hotline Bling, but like a Travis Scott version. See what kind of 808 pattern we want. So I might take out the kick. Let me see. Where's the kick? So I'm going to do this. Let's pull it up an octave, control up. Octave, and then when we're switching the root note, I'm just doing an octave of that root note. Boom, boom, boom. And I'm going to do a G sharp an octave higher. So a lot of octave play with 808s. Could go from A sharp to D sharp, or I could do a D sharp octave. So let's try D sharp octave higher first. I like that a little bit better. Now let's pull everything down an octave. They can barely hear it, so let's add some distortion on the 808. There are so many ways to add distortion. I'm going to use decapitator for now, but you can add fruity blood overdrive, you could do fruity squeeze, fruity wave shaper. There's so many plugins you can use. I'm going to put it on punish mode and turn the mix level down. That's going to add some aggression using that saturation. But you lose a little low end, so you got to compensate. It's not matching with the music. So I'm gonna go doom, boom, boom, bing. Now, I know the 808's not following the kick, that's fine. Drake slide effect, go to the wrench tool, turn on portamento, and you could even turn on monophonic just so the pitch bends. This and I need to add a vocal to it to kind of liven it up. So what I'll do is add a vocal idea and mix it roughly. I'm not going to spend, you know, days on days mixing this. Just want to give you a presentable image of what this could turn into. So I'll play the beat twice by itself, then I'm going to go back, add vocal ideas to it, mix it a little bit, and show you the dramatic difference. So let's play the beat twice as is. Okay, so let's get into the vocal idea in part two. Again, this whole sound came from music theory because we started with the music, then we worked around sound design, customizing those sounds. So if you want to learn more about music theory, go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory. We have free videos for you there and a lot of free project files and a lot of free bonuses as well. And that's the majority of the sound. So let's add that vocal and then let's do a little mixing. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com. Create complete compositions with comprehension. Master music theory. Visit busyworksbeats.com/music theory for your free bonuses and free music theory tutorials. Professional mixing secrets finally revealed. Get three free videos straight from the new Mixing Academy complete course package at busyworksbeats.com/mac. Want to learn how to make beats like the pros? Join now for free at busyworksbeats.com and learn the secrets of the pros.